Hello, YouTube. Welcome back to the Elden Ring PC Let's Play. Can you believe it's already episode 14? Wow. Okay. So last we left off, we had just improved our strength up to 13, and we are almost ready to wield that key crossbow, which will be neat. I haven't really played with a crossbow much. A lot of soldiers and things drop crossbow bolts, so that'll be nice to have at our disposal. So looking at the map here, let's see what we can do today. So we have this section here, which is kind of barren. And we have this bridge that we can go over. It looks like there's some ruins here. This is where Yura, the hunter of the Bloody Fingers, is at. Why don't we go talk to him real quick and see if he's got anything new to say. One thing about Yura that nobody can argue. That hat. Thinking about how impractical that hat is, especially for combat scenarios, like how you're not going to be able to see things, you'll only be able to see partial things. I'll bet you there's some kind of story behind that hat. Like, yeah. Well, on the other hand of the argument, I guess, if we're having one, he has more holes than a traditional helm. I don't know. It just doesn't seem very comfortable, but it definitely would protect your neck, I would imagine, unless they could get kind of under there, and then your head is, depending on if it's like, looks just like a pillow underneath, and then, I don't know. Maybe he flips it over and uses it for other purposes. What those would be, I don't know. Looks like it could do some other things, though. Like a filter of some kind. Maybe he sifts for golden runes. Maybe he's a miner. Or maybe it's just a nice hat and he doesn't really think that hard about it. He just likes it.
I can tell you want to see it through. Fools will be fools. Fight all the dragons you like.
Okay. Cool. We're not going to fight a dragon, though, today. For a number of reasons. One, I don't think that's the best use of our time at this stage. Our vigor, if you look on the thing here, our vigor is only going to take maybe two or three hits tops. And the kind of player I am, I need to be able to tank more damage. So once we get our strength up to 14, I think we're going to start working on our faith. We're going to try and get faith at least up to the point where we can use that heal incantation. And then from there, we might go back to vigor. Or we might start working on some intelligence. I just want some basic levels in intelligence. I don't think I'm going to be magic based. Actually, I've decided I kind of don't want to be because not there's anything wrong with magic. And I probably will use a bit of it because it's too good to not use, right? I'll use any tools that are given. But I did that already in my other playthrough, which I haven't beaten, by the way. When I say my other playthrough, that sounds kind of like I've beaten the game. I've beat, the farthest I got in my game was I just beat the third boss, and I'm not going to even say who that is, in case you're watching this and you want spoiler free, which you're not going to get here, by the way. But, yeah, so I don't, and I like it, but it's just, I find I'm becoming too, what's the word? I'm becoming too complacent with magic because it's so good. It's just so much I'm choosing my words wisely here. It's so much more fun and easy to just be like swing swing with spells, you know, pew pews and stuff. And I want to check out some of these new these other Ashes of War, because I was very Ash of War light in my other playthrough on Xbox. I shouldn't say playthrough, to say when I was playing on Xbox, then the statement doesn't need to be further clarified. right? Okay. What are we doing? We're just running around, running around. Alright, let's, but what I want to get better at is this and this and this, right? That's what I want to get better at. I don't want to be a one-trick kind of player. And actually, it's funny, we've already discovered this, right? Yeah, okay, that's where we started. It's actually kind of funny in that when I'm done playing, I have this moment of reflection. Let's see how much damage we do to these little squid dudes. Aw, they were about to hold hands. Oh, wow, we're one-shotting them. Okay. Yeah. Wow. Okay. Yeah, this is a... Oh, we're not... They're not quite dead. They're not quite dead. But now they are. And the flail can hit more than one enemy at a time. I think all weapons can. But anyway. What I was saying is I stop to reflect a little bit after I'm done playing, and I think about all of the mistakes that I made. Just kind of my nature to analyze. And... Ooh, how do we get down there? Yeah, let's go down there. How do we... Okay. It's in my nature to analyze. And so I think, like, okay, if I just calm down. Like, the theme for me... I'm actually going to gesture this because I think there is one. Is it this? No, it's not. Wait. There's one that's like, calm down, Beavis. Warm welcome. Maybe I don't have it yet. Yeah, I don't have it yet. But, I just need to chill a little. I need to be less about my reactions and panics. Like, here, let's try and put this into practice. And I'm thinking about it in a way like I used to when I played Street Fighter. In Street Fighter, I would watch my opponent... Oh, wow, I never noticed how they did that with their teeth. Do that again. That was cool. Did you guys see that? Look at that. Oh, that's okay. That was worth it. Just to see the check, 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 check. Oh, wow. That's really cool. There's another example of why I want to just kind of not use magic all the time. Because if I was using magic in this case, this is me speaking for myself. Nobody else. I would have been like, pew, pew, and just moved on, right? I wouldn't have had a chance to really see that. That was really cool. They're like, chuck, 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 with their teeth. Anyway, when I played Street Fighter as a younger man, I always saw at the arcade, the best players were the ones that kept their composure. They didn't get shook, right? They weren't shook. And... the confidence, I think, was what led to their victories a lot. I think, as with a lot of games and sports and athleticism and stuff, it's not so much your ability to play as it is your ability to manage your own kind of, like, instincts, right? So, I'm trying to get... Oh, now I can't stop hearing those teeth. It's actually giving me a little bit of a... like nails on chalkboard kind of thing. On my skin bumps. Anyway, it's like the best players were always figuring out a way to take advantage of every mistake that the other player made. And it wasn't so much they were defensive. Oh, I never noticed that. Oh, that's disgusting. That's guano, I think. Isn't it? And he's got... Oh no, his head is still attached. But they basically drained this guy's body fully of all fluid. And then they just have been living here, feeding off of his corpse. And also using it as their restroom. Well, they are gross creatures, at any rate. I just love the monster designs in FromSoft games. It's just so rad. So anyway, back to the conversation that I was trying to have with myself and anyone paying attention. In Street Fighter, the way that I had a breakthrough moment was I was constantly on the offensive, just trying to spaz and like take people out. Be unpredictable was my strategy And it wasn't even really a strategy. It was like, okay, I am not going to use medium, right? I found that mediums took. See, I can't. I don't know if I can hit. Well, I can hit him with my bow, and I think he'll spawn. Yeah, let's watch him for a minute. Let's try not to get. That's so cool. Oh my goodness. It sounds like a, like from a sound effect perspective. Oh, that's so cool. I don't even care. Like, chew my face, man. That's awesome. Anyway, I found my breakthrough moment happened when I started making conscious decisions. Oh, dude, look at how much blood is on me. I mean, I am Grey Worm, so, like, I'm not averse to blood, right? Like, defending Khaleesi, you have to be kind of over all that, right? Anyway, I will eventually get to this point when I said, okay, I'm not going to use medium. And medium is a type of attack in Street Fighter. If you don't know about Street Fighter, it's a combat game that it's kind of like one-on-one. And there are moves and special moves and things in the game that you can do. And you do these moves with combos. Like you use like different control combos and stuff. So there's a manual dexterity component to it. There's a muscle memory component to it. There's a strategy component to it. And the game was obviously super popular. So I'm probably over explaining something everybody already knows. But the point is medium attacks. Medium attacks didn't appeal to me because of my, I think it's because of my very polarizing way of thinking, where it's either one or the other, right? And I kind of blame growing up with computers for this, but very much I noticed that when you use a medium, it's kind of like in between both of them. And that's good, but it's like, you know, I also played baseball as a kid, and there was this idea when you were pitching. Obviously, this is over-explaining again because everybody knows how baseball works, but basically, you do a change-up, and you do that to catch your opponent off guard. In that case, if you're the pitcher, it's the batter, which also I just now thought about. That's interesting. Anywho, when I said I'm not using mediums, I'm only using jabs and fierces, because I noticed others were using mediums almost in like experimental ways. They wouldn't even, like, there wasn't a deliberate decision to use a medium. It just happened that their hand or their fingers may have hit those buttons because they were in fight or flight mode. And I wasn't smart enough to realize this, obviously, and be able to articulate it. I just said, oh, I don't like that. It's taking too long for me to do something and I want it fast. So I came up with combos that would utilize jabs and fierce as a kind of like a, not necessarily a consistent final attack. Okay, let's see if we can go down here. But to keep them off guard, I would sometimes just use jabs for a whole fight, and it would just drive them nuts because they knew he's beating me with only, you know, fast, small damage attacks, but he's consistently kicking my butt. That's really frustrating. So it would shake them. It would, like, their composure, even really good players that were way better at the manual dexterity component of the game, would start to lose their composure. And I would just stay quiet, you know, and, you know, look, I'm painting it like I'm some kind of pro master at Street Fighter. I wasn't, but that was a game that I focused, right? I focused. I said, I'm playing Roy or Ryu or however you want to say it, where you come from. I need to go over there. And that's it. I'm not going to play any other characters. And I did that and I focused on it. And then I became known as the Ryu guy or Roy. And everybody was like, oh, here comes the Ryu guy. I mean, they didn't say that. They're like, hey, Rick. Right? They didn't call me Ryu. That's crazy. We're not that nerdy. Anywho. But it became a thing where I was just, you know, and all of us had characters that we played, me and my friends. And one of my buddies was Ken, and he was super good. Like, this guy, man, he has, like, he'd be a great, I bet you, actually, I haven't talked to him in a long time, but I bet you he would be an awesome YouTuber. because he would he was like one of those naturally talented gamers that he just had so much ability, and it looked so effortless when he would play stuff. And he wasn't a dick, and he was fun and funny. He had a great sense of humor, which are all very endearing qualities to have in a friend who's kicking your ass at Street Fighter on a regular basis. Can I drop? Drop? Let's see. And I don't have any of those things, but I did pick up, yeah, so we can make one. All right, let's just make one. And let's put this back. I find these things useful. I'm going to put them back here for now when I'm in exploratory mode. So I don't have to go in. No, that's death. I'm glad I did that. Now, I wonder if I had my water wings on my feet, if I could still do it. I think over here it might be safe. There's got to be a way to get down there. First of all. Oh, there's a spirit spring. Never mind. So being Ryu and focusing on only specific things, and then there was like a, I hate to overuse the term, a meta element to the success that I was finding in the game. And that meta element was something that's intangible in all games, in all competition, and that is composure and that ability to keep somebody. Here, let's get away from here because we learned our lesson. We don't want to jump off there. Let's somehow A, maintain our own composure, and B, ruin or impact the composure of my opponent. And yeah, so anyway, by focusing in Elden Ring, because there's so many choices. There's so many choices, like in Street Fighter, you couldn't change your equipment to a different kind. You only had one special, you know, set of things that you could do. Who's this guy? Let's heal up. He looks kind of tough. And that forced me to be minimal, to take a minimal approach, because there was only like, what, the kick move, the uppercut, and the ranged one. So the ranged one was like, shoget, and then the uppercut was like, oh, you good. And then the kick one was like, let's see if we can get this on. Get him! Oh, he's quick to react. All right, okay. Let's see. Okay, he's got big purple magic. That's not good. But he's not doing too much damage to us. Let's see how we... Okay, it's not that much range on that attack. So, this kind of... Whoa, he sucked me into him. So, this realization that I had also applies to Elden Ring. Because if you think about it, every fight you have is one-on-one. Even if there's more than one opponent that you're fighting at a time, at that time, your moveset... Oh, yep, nope, don't wait for the wind-up for that. Is all about managing your own composure, and in a case of a computer game, it's obviously they don't really have composure, they have programming, right? They know that... Oh, okay, okay, good, he can't hit me there. Let's roll forward. And then the timing is very important as well. And then, see, here's a situation where I should have not attacked as much. I find when I'm getting closer and I'm getting damage, what happens is my brain is like, keep doing that, you're doing a good job. There's the positive reinforcement that occurs. And I don't necessarily always... Like, this is an example, right? I was just spamming, you might even... heard it. Which is not pro Elden Ring style. Ash of War Gravitas. What is this? Well, before I check it out, I want to finish my statement. So, in a game like Elden Ring, it's up to you how you play. So you could focus on one weapon, like this other fine gentleman, this Sunbro named The Preacher Plays, that also has this mentality. I think, I don't know if he's as deliberate about it or if it's just he has preferences and he's more instinctual, you know, and he intuitively makes his decisions. I don't know. I can't speak for him. But he's been using the same weapon, which is a double-sided... what is it? Here, we have it, but we're not going to use it because it's his. Twin blade. And I noticed, you know, I kind of cheated and I skipped ahead on his Let's Play because I'm so far behind. I'm only on, like, the 30th episode or something. And I noticed that he's been using the twin blade, like, consistently the whole time. And he's just wrecking stuff. Like, and I think he's been upgrading it. I don't know. I haven't gotten to a point where he's needed to depend on any of these gimmicks. Like, he's just good. He's good at the game. He's able to, like, not, you know, react in the same way as, like I was saying, he has composure. And the same is true of Blue Lizard Jello, right? The other Let's Player that I've been kind of following for a little more than a year or two. Like, those guys, they just have this innate ability to know when not to do something. And it's, I think that's one of the things that separates the good players. Ooh, what's this? From people like me. And then, you know, waiting, and then Blue Lizard Jello, from henceforth I'm just going to say Blue when I'm referring to a YouTuber context. There's only one Blue in my world, and it's Blue Lizard Jello. So Blue, he will say things like, I need something to punish, show me something that I can punish. And that right there, I think he's really eloquently, with a hell of a lot less words, explained what I was trying to say, in that you take advantage of the opportunities that your opponent gives you, and punish them for trying it, right? Like, you're saying, hey, nope, that's not going to work on me. I've learned my lesson. Right. And that was true for me in Street Fighter. And then, so I was thinking about it, as I said, not long ago. Maybe it was even last night. I don't know. I find in COVID times, I have a hard time stringing together a chronological order of any kind of sense at all. Like, it's just one big giant existence with a few bookends of sunlight once in a while in each chapter of the whatever alliteration I'm trying to say. Okay, there's a crab down there, but there is a shiny. I'm gonna guess this is probably something really weak. I don't think that's gonna be very good. First of all, if we look at the situation, this guy was just rowing around, then something happened, crabs got him. And his boot was destroyed. His boot was destroyed. His boot was destroyed. Anyway. So I had that epiphany. Oh, wait. Elden Ring is like Street Fighter. Ah, okay. So now I can start to focus. And it's up to me if I want to use gazillions of different weapon types. There's lots of different ones to choose from. It's up to me what Ash of War I want to use. There's tons. But I can build my own Ryu. I can build my own... you know, obviously character, which is duh, it's an RPG. Brilliant, right? Like, great job, Captain Obvious. But the thing is, it didn't occur to me. So right now, it is a big deal. It is a big deal to me. So there's one. I'm gonna probably shoot this guy. Like, it's pretty clear they put this here for this reason. And then, oop, I forgot he had that chism attack. Sorry if that's uncouth. Ooh. Okay, don't get under the awning of safety over here. Let's just kind of keep him aggro. Hey, I'm still over here. Come and look at me. Okay, he's going to try and go around. His AI was starting to. And then it's like, nope, character's closer. Turn around and then do that and then make them punish them. Basically, the AI also works, I think, on this level of programming too, and that also was like an epiphanous moment when I thought about that. Look at him, he's doing a tap dance. He's a tap dancing man. So we're gonna just shoot this sucker. I mean, we could try to be fancy, but like, we got this gangster bow. Why not? Pop, pop, pop. Well, we can make more arrows. I like this idea, especially considering how little health I have. Although, let me use this guy. And I'm going to have a little bit less risk. So it's about... I think this game, and I think the people who are good at it, maybe know this, like, just out of, like, default way that they think, and they're super smart. There's a consistency in the way they play. Whereas the new players, like myself, we're not consistent, and we keep changing. Oh, nice! We got a Crimson Tears back. That'll be nice to use. Where's the shiny at? Did I get it? Did I already pick it up? I probably did, and I didn't even notice. Okay, well, I don't even know what I got. I'll have to look at the video. Anyway, that's when I'm thinking in my head, you know, I'm replaying my mistakes and I'm looking at, sometimes I'll watch the video. I don't know if I'm the only one that does that, but it's kind of like in when you do, I guess that one of the analogies you can make is when you go and learn how to play golf and there's the swing, right? Everything is dependent on a lot of things that may not be immediately obvious, like the way your feet are pointing or whatever. And I don't, by the way, I'm not a golfer. I don't have proof of any of this. It's more just like, hey, that makes sense. Let's say these things. But I do know that like where your feet are pointed does matter. So, but you might not know that if you're not a pro golfer, but then you take lessons and they actually record you. I think they use cameras of like some special nature that have a certain motion, like they can capture so many frames per second to analyze your swing better and to look at different things and to give you advice. And the same is true in a lot of sports. Like even before the internet and digital media kind of took over analog, they used to do that. Like football players would do it, baseball players. And it's funny, I'm not a sports guy, but I'm starting to realize maybe I am, but I'm a player and not a like person who can say, hey, that guy is good at that point winning ability. Like he's a good hitter or whatever. I don't know. I don't know. There's a lot of things that are happening in my mind right now that I can't really think about in a good way. And what I mean by good is a thorough way that is going to change anything in my life for the better. Or your ability to watch me. Okay, so let's get out of here. I think we've cleaned all of this out. We found that back door, I guess, because that was to where we started when we were in the tutorial mode. So that's cool. And we got another Ash of War. Wow, it's almost 30 minutes already. So here's the thing. We came down here so that we could get up on that other precipice. So we're doing that. That's going to happen. That is happening. So let's do that. Hopefully you're understanding a little bit of my babbling. Like, I'm not just trying to be a filibuster and say, hey, this is what I really mean. No, I mean, oh no, I'm gonna die. Oh, wow. They're very forgiving with that. No, I mean these things, and I'm gonna start actually putting effort into the micro experiences of this game, which is, I think, it's gonna be one of the better ways to enjoy it. Can I not get up there? I guess I healed because, I don't know, in my brain that made sense. You've got to be able to get up here somehow. It's got to be possible. Maybe I just have to push more that way sooner? Okay. Maybe I jump like this sooner to get an angle. No, frack. Maybe I can? Or maybe there's another way to do it. And you can hear my bulldog. Actually, I'm actually going to pause it just a moment. All right. Sorry about that. Our bulldog wanted on the couch. I'm gonna try one more time. And I know I can get to this, but that's not really... Oh, wait. Can I... Wait a minute. Let's see. Can we do this? Well, we don't have... we don't have any of them. And we don't have the spell. So we're gonna die if we drop down there. That's what the stone said, right? Like, it broke? I don't even remember. You've gotta be able to get over there. You've gotta. I refuse to believe... Well, here, let's not waste this opportunity, obviously, to get all of our flasks back. Let's go to morning. The other thing I was going to say before I lose the point and the potency of what I was trying to articulate very badly, very poorly, is blue has said this a few times, and I caught on to what he said. He's managing. He manages the situations. And I've heard the Preacher Play say this as well. And this is probably something that, because Dark Souls teaches you, like the game teaches you how to do these things, whether you realize it or not. It teaches you. Hopefully I don't die. And then, okay, I didn't die. Great. So all that time I was being super careful for no reason. Anyway, I don't like to be on the horse on precarious ledges and things. But the game teaches you how to do things like that. And smart people like Blue and the Preacher Plays and those guys, they realize it, and probably others besides them, I'm sure of it, also realize that you manage the situation. So the game isn't just hit, kill, jump, duck, run, roll. It's also, hey, be wary of where you're at. Use the environment to your benefit, to your advantage. Like, here's an example with this wolf. Like, and obviously some of this relates to AI and programming. Ooh, that was nice. I didn't expect that. You know, let's see if we can see if he's going to stagger us. Okay, nope. Oh, but he did have a quick follow-up that did defeat. So right there, here's a good example. We just learned that this isn't even a sure thing. If they have a quick follow-up, they can break you out of your guard counter. And those are things that I think the guy who, or the people, whoever made the FromSoft folks, they played some D&D in Street Fighter. Absolutely. Because they've taken all of those, like, very little experiences and bundled them into a package of fun. Like, managing the environment we did just there. That was, you know, it only took like 30 seconds maybe for me. For a pro player, it'd probably be like 1 second, right? But that was fun. So, like, and I feel, well, I was punished, right, for not knowing that there was a guard counter defeater, which is speed. It's just speed. These are attributes that you don't have, right? So let me just try and frame it. In here, right, HP. This is a stat that is just, you know, how many mistakes you can make before you die. And it's just a bar, and you can refill your mistake meter. This one here determines FP in focus. This is like what you're using to make the other thing make a mistake. And then you have endurance, which is how quickly you can recover, right? Or how quickly you can repeat or riposte or whatever. And then you also have strength, which is just brute strength and the ability to wield different armaments and defense. Then you have this. So let's read this for a minute. Attribute required to wield advanced armaments also boosts attack power of dexterity scaling armaments, reduces casting time of spells, softens fall damage, and makes it harder to be knocked off your horse. Okay, so nowhere in there does it say speed, right? So if that's true and there's no speed statistic, then it's all about the weapon itself and how fast or slow its animation is and how you choose to wield it. So the flail, if you look, and I'm not going to analyze frames or anything, that's silly. I couldn't even take advantage of them anyway. But like 1, 2, 3, 4, there's a point when my weapon is going to intersect with whatever programming line or box or whatever. How do I get down? Oh boy. How do I get down? I didn't even think about... I just tried to get up, but now how do I get down? And that wolf just educated me. Okay, right here. It looks like maybe I jump there. I'm gonna die. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna die. Yeah, pretty sure. Oh no, maybe not. Maybe not. That looks kind of far. I'm gonna try it anyway. I'm gonna heal up before I do, just in case. Okay. Hey, and I didn't even take any damage. No damage. Okay. I don't know if I can use the horse to get over there. Obviously someone did. They've made their mark. Over there. I don't think there's anything over there. We could try. I mean, we're gonna have to get down anyway. What's the point in not trying? Oh yeah, we could totally make this jump. Be careful. I wish there was like a sneak mode for Mr. Torrent. Okay, where's that spring? Okay, that guy's back because I rested. Oh, no, I'm dead. Oh, no, I'm not dead. Okay, good. But like, think about it for a moment, and it might make more sense than what I'm saying to you, but the way they've designed this game is to teach you also how to be better. And I think this is something that the pros realize, and they start to understand how to become better faster, and they realize the mechanics of the game and all that. Anyway, I'm going to stop talking about all that crap. That's ridiculous that I talked this long about that. But yeah, see, here's the starting area. And here's a case in point. We can't get back up without using the Spirit Spring, but they gave us a choice. We could go back this way if we want. Right, so now we have a shortcut. And one of the things that separates these games from the others are these kind of things that teach you overall about things and give you a chance to really understand and become a better player. I don't think I have any swords. So all of those things might be lost on someone new to the game, or someone who's more like, you know, they're trying to get through it. They want to beat it. They want the achievements or whatever it might be, right? Whereas an old person like me who used to play Street Fighter and is a slow learner, obviously, because it's taken me this long to make these connections. Might take their sweet time and just absorb everything. Like, I don't know. This is a full-on masterpiece to me. The storytelling has gaps, and it's kind of weird how you have to exhaust dialogue and all that, but honestly, I think that I've had more fun and a personal relationship. Sorry for the poppy pop. A personal relationship with this game. And that's another thing that I think is an intangible that the FromSoft formula gives you, is you start to... The game has a personality and an identity to it. It's not just some generic system of things connected together to exploit, you know, your wallet. You know, like, you don't have to go and buy... I'm not talking about microtransactions, but, like, you're enjoying yourself. Like, you don't... And it's up to you how much time you take and all that kind of thing. But, like, you... In these games, over any other game I've ever played, I know the lay of the land. Way better. Way, 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 way better than any other game. And this is absolutely true for Dark Souls 1. That was the first game where I... it was so bad. Oh, I mean, that game's about being careful. Among other things, I'm sure. But for me, my strategy was, okay, memorize what's going to happen. Don't make the same mistakes. And then... go further. Like, that was the loop, right? So the first time you get to a new area, you're gonna die a lot, but then you start learning, and it's almost like a game of concentration in that regard, wherein you have this memory of things that are happening and these scenes in your mind, these pictures, right? And then you get this fight or flight that happens at the same time, which seems to like engrave it into your brain. It's just such a cool thing. I don't know how else. It's really difficult to articulate what I'm saying. I'm sure that you guys who get it, and those who don't are like, this guy is crazy. Who is this guy? What kind of nut job am I watching? But I'm starting to understand the passion that people have for the love of these things, because the game is an entity. This game is an entity. And so is pretty much all of those types of games that they've made. From the beginning to the... I don't know. I mean, I've only played Dark Souls 1. I played Dark Souls 2 a little bit. Not very much. I played Dark Souls 3 a little bit. Mostly because I just didn't have the time to invest. I didn't have time to make friends with it, right? Like this one. And this one is a little bit more chill in between, obviously. This is like COVID souls. Right? Like, this is like pandemic souls, where you know, the company who even makes these games is like, all right, we need these people to just kind of relax also. We don't want them to constantly be beaten up and everything. But if they want to be sadistic, they can be. They could also just pick flowers. anyway. Like, here's an example. We're picking flowers. Now, we're murdering giant bugs. Oh, or getting stomped on by giants. And, or stuck in their feet. Alright, let's try and put into practice. This will be the last thing we do, I think, in this episode, because it's too long. But, so we have these things that we're doing here. We've got a tree. Well, we had a tree. And now we're going to get wrecked, and we won't have time to learn. So let's just get out of here. Let's get out of here. Nope, don't crawl. Let's just move. Let's run. Right? Let's run away and see if we can manage this environment. So we have elevation. We have vegetation, things that are going to be blocking our way. But the giant, they've just taught us, that giant doesn't abide by the same rule systems that our size class does. They can modify the environment. So we need to modulate our behavior to be able to use that to our advantage somehow. And usually they have something around that you could play smarter and not just be a better eye-hand coordination kind of player. That's another thing that I really love about these games. It might not be obvious, but usually that's the case. So let's see. First of all, this is not a good area to fight a big guy like that in. There's too many things that are going to block us around, and this is a little bit better. All right, let's see if we can figure this out. So timing. What I've learned is roll when the attack starts, and then stop rolling until you see another animation follow up or some kind of tell. Right. So just keep rolling when that attack animation starts. And it's not always the case, and some are faster. No, now in that case, that was dumb. But we can get close and bust up his kneecaps. Man, that would really hurt when you think about it. Okay, so there's an example where there's an area of effect attack. And when that happens, you can jump to avoid being on the ground and take that collateral damage. Oopsie, no, I was just talking about the environment. Okay. What else you got, buddy? So this, in my mind, the kind of like thing that I'm thinking about is, in Street Fighter, this is like fighting a computer opponent. So we punish him for, he punished us there. We punished him for having that moment where he was down, right? When his animation kept him lower and vulnerable. And I'm going to turn off this thing, because I don't think I need that crutch as much. That's another thing that I've noticed, is this lock-on mechanic. And this happens in Rocket League as well. The best players, they don't use that, first of all. They don't use the lock-on. That's not what I wanted. That's what I wanted. Okay, so now he's going to pick his weapon up and start really wrecking us. I don't know if that's because... Okay, good. We got behind him. Oh, there's a follow-up. Okay. Okay, that's enough. Okay. And if you think about it from this guy's perspective, he is... Oh, no, he's wrecking me. But, like, right there, that fight was like a mini Street Fighter session right there. And it was better because it was strategic. I was using elevation, and he was using elevation, and he was using the environment. I really enjoyed that, even if I lost, because I didn't lose. I learned. So I still won, in my mind. Now, whether or not you can get on board with that is up to you. I'm going to go get my runes, and then we're going to end it. But these things, those experiences are... everywhere in these games. Everywhere. If you just take a second to like look at them and find them and really, really appreciate all of the work that has gone into this. Like, I want to fight these bats. I want to learn from these bats. Like, you know, that's not how you're going to do it. That's not how you're going to win. I don't want to die. Obviously, no one wants to die. But I do want to make myself feel better for that loss, so to speak. Like, I did lose. I mean, let's be honest. If we're talking about, like, that binary did or did not, the duality of our existence that we are constantly reminded about, I did lose. He's alive. I'm not. I got to go get my stuff. His stuff's in him. He still got his runes. Right? So... you son of a biscuit. There he goes, changing the program on me, throwing me that knuckleball. Yeah, now we're bloodied again. And now we're ready. We've got our... Right there, those two things that just happened. Granted, I wasn't flawlessly doing them. I freaking love that animation. That's so cool. Check, 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 check. Granted, those situations exist, but now the game said, all right, you made a mistake. You know how to beat these guys. You beat them so many times. They're not giants, but you can still practice on them, right? These are your buddies that you're playing catch with in the backyard. You're learning, and you're gonna be better. You're gonna be taking those giants out like those bats at some point. And that progression, you're going to feel good about. You're going to be like, oh, I am actually not horrible. Finally. And maybe you'll never be like that. But at the very least, you'll see more of the game. You'll see more of all this beauty that they've created for us to behold. Because you won't be dying. You won't have to constantly die and come back. And, you know, there's all these other systems in here. They've made it more friendly than the original game. And like I said, I don't feel like I'm even entitled to say these things because I've never beaten a single Souls game. Not one. Not yet, anyway. I always play them to the point where I get just pummeled and I'm like, I'm already stressed out. I really don't want to play this anymore. But I think that's doing this game a disservice, thinking about it that way. It's doing the whole idea of, you know, a game that teaches you a disservice. Well, it might be if you keep making the same mistake. That's not the game's fault. The game is the game. You just keep on butting your head against this brick wall. And if you decide to do that and you enjoy that, then fine. But at a certain point for me, did I just find a... Okay. I just get so overwhelmed with, like, self-loathing. I suck. And I'm already stressed from work. And I'm just like, you know what? Skeletons, you're going to have to just go away. I need a break. So anyway, I am sorry for that rambling. But I did really enjoy talking it out and trying to understand more about how the game inside the game works, right? Like the fact that there's no speed attribute in that. I learn something new every time I play this game. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you're enjoying this. And if you bailed long ago, you wouldn't even hear this. So you don't matter to me. And that's fine with me and fine with you. So take it easy. Have a great weekend. And I'll see you again soon.